Nestruck.
Hey, welcome back to Let's Play Star Fox, or more specifically, Snestrunk plays Star Fox. I always get that wrong. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to show off how to get to the black hole. So, no insinuations there, no innuendo. The black hole in Star Fox. Not going to lie, I'm a little tipsy. I've had... let's see, about 300 milliliters of Jameson. I wonder how many ounces that is. Because I know 1 ounce, or not one ounce. Is 1 ounce a shot or is 2 ounces a shot? I forget. Can't remember. But anyway, where you want to go is on the first path, the easiest path, the middle path. He doesn't matter. I'll help him anyway because I'm a good... I try and be a good person sometimes, so sue me. Middle path, and then it's the second stage after the Corneria. It's the asteroid field, asteroid belt. None of this shit matters. You want to keep going. Gotta amble your way through this very dramatic asteroid field. Yawn. You want to get to the asteroids that are spinning around like a windmill. Windmill. Am I saying that Minnesotan enough? Windmill. Like a windmill. Let's smash them. Yeah, that's great, Peppy. Okay, this should be coming up here. There it is. So, you want to wait till you get extreme close-up. Whoa! If you smash into it, it's fine as long as you destroy the middle asteroid somehow. You want to shoot it as soon as you get really close to it. Like that. And if you run into some other stuff, so be it. And then, after that, you'll see a troll face looking asteroid. Shoot it. And that will bring up the black hole. And here we go. Very spooky music. Now, I believe... Now, this is a nice touch here. Let me... Oh, wait. I got it wrong. The other one is a nice touch. This is like... This space graveyard created by Andros' experiments is where your father vanished. Nice reference to his dad and his disappearance, I guess, but... How can he keep in contact with him if he's in a black hole? But whatever. Yeah, and it really is just like a graveyard. There's just a bunch of random shit flying around. And there's even extra lives in here. You can claim the lost lives of others. Maybe that extra life there was actually his father's life. You ever think of that? Anyway, you just kind of keep going. And if you want to teleport to the next... to further up the path... You go through that ring. Now, I don't remember off the top of my head which ring goes to which path. I believe the first ring goes to the second path, the second ring goes to the third path, and the third ring goes to the first path, I think, off the top of my head. And so I want to just, yeah, I think it goes 2-3-1. Look, you even see like fragments of bosses and stuff in here, which is a really nice touch. They got the metal crusher there. Now, I'm going to go through this ring, and I think this takes me to Venom on the first path. Let's see. Yep, takes you straight to Venom. Even though you're facing to the right like you came from the second path, you're actually still on the first path. Okay, so... Let us edit our way to the next thing I want to show off, which is, I don't even know what to call it. I forget what it's called off the top of my head, but you want to go to the hardest path, the third path, level 3, and you want to go again to the asteroid field.
Good luck.
And you want to pay attention and look for... one of those big asteroids on the right side that looks like it's part of the background, but it really isn't. You'll know it when you see it. Ooh. And you don't matter, Falco, so go fuck yourself. Keep an eye out for... I don't remember off the top, but it's been a long time. Yeah, see the asteroid on the left there? That big thing that looks like it's part of the background? It looks like that, but it's on the right side. In fact, I think that's it right there. You just keep shooting at it. It'll blow up. Out comes an egg. And a bird comes out. And what you have to do is you have to fly into the bird. And I'm going to exit my... this perspective here to get up to it closer, and that, there you go. Now suddenly we are, where are we? We're off the map entirely. Shit, where did this thing come from? More spooky music. Now this is the nice touch, what I really, out of this dimension. Come in, R-Wings. Fox, where are you? We need you to protect Corneria. Like, he's out of radio contact. He doesn't know where the hell he happened to him. And you get here, and it's all stupid. I mean, just look at this. Just listen to this music. You got pieces of paper flying around. There really is no threat. There's hardly any enemies other than paper airplanes and these logs here, pillars. And yeah, this is the most ridiculous thing. I have to believe that this stage was the result of pure overwork. Of the developers were just so tired and so worn out and so like, fuck this game. Let's just do the stupidest thing we can imagine just to, you know, just to have some fun and blow off steam and whatever. Anyway, yeah, this level pretty much stays like this. This is a nice Easter egg in this game though, because I had played this game for many years before I had ever found out about this. And so it's always really cool when you come across something like that. Whoa, look out. I mean, what other game... I can't even think of another example of a game that where that was the case. Where, like, I had no idea this existed until I saw it on YouTube. It was like a tutorial of, like, how to find the out-of-this-dimension thing. I was like, the hell are you talking about? It must be like a ROM hack or something like that. But sure enough, it's in the actual game. So hey, maybe if you've played this game for a long time and you never knew about this, now you do. Just passing along the information. Let's get those floating pieces of paper up there. Yeah, the only downside of this level is that it's pretty frickin' dull. There's not a lot going on, unless you're really into paper airplanes. Eventually, we will get to the quote-unquote boss. And, yeah, actually, we are here. And, look out. What is it? What could it be? What evil device is this? It's a slot machine. And it kind of dances or waddles. You shoot the lever, and you sit here like this, and, uh-oh, I got Andross level, oh god, I'm too drunk for this, oh shit, I was not prepared to defend myself, I guarantee you I'm gonna die, oh, I was all ready to have a good time and play a slot machine, but if you get the Andross head as one of the things, oh no, then you get missiles at you, and god, I'm not prepared for this. I drank way too much before recording this. Anyway, to quote unquote beat this boss, you need to get 3 sevens. There's one. What, I didn't win anything? And sometimes you have the option of locking something in place by shooting one of the three triangles down there. And I got another fucking Andross. God damn it. Oh no, please don't do this to me. Damn it. Oh god, and I ended up locking all three accidentally. Which means I'm gonna get the exact same thing. Can I unlock these? Fuck. Yeah, this is totally random. Oh no, I'm gonna... I'm gonna freaking die, aren't I? God damn it. Okay, I'm just gonna edit my way back to there. I'm not gonna make you sit through that boring ass level again. I'll see you when I'm back at the slot machine. Okay, we're back. And, yeah, this is just totally random. I want to show off what happens when you actually win something, though. God damn it! I have the freaking worst luck so far. I just keep getting the stupid Andross head. I'm not gonna die this time. This is what happens when you don't... Don't drink and play slot machines, kids. Anyway, come on. Just win something already, will ya? Still nothing? Jeez. Come on. No Andross. Yay. I won space coins that mean utterly nothing. I think they might give you life if you if you need it. Anyway, you literally sit here. It can take as long as an hour before you get 3 sevens. I'll fast forward to when it actually happens. Uh-oh. Look out! There it is! Alright! Gives me all of its space coins. And... it explodes. I wish real slot machines did that. and the sky corrects itself so you can see all the smiling planets. And you get the credits, although you get to fly around with the credits. It's completely stupid. Oh my. Yeah, that's all this is. Although there is a little bit of a treat towards the end once you get to the end of the credits. Take this, Miyamoto! What do you think of that? Take this, Iguchi! I'm gonna fast. We've all seen the credits like 3 times now, so let's fast forward. Okay, once we get to the end, then we can shoot the letters! Yeah! Oh, but not only that, we also get enemies and stuff for some reason. I don't understand why. This is so ridiculous. Anyway, I want to get the letters a certain way. Might as well use the bomb since it's there. I want to get the letters a certain way to the... get out of here. Get out of my way. Get everything the way it's supposed to be. Get orange. Whoops, didn't mean to do that. Orange and right side up, like that. This could take a while, folks. Hey, how dare you? Hey, he messed up my frickin' letter by exploding into it. Damn it. At least that guy kinda helped me. There we go, now we're just 2 letters away. We're just 1 letter away. Come on, T. There we go. And it switches the music back. And it just comes right back. That's all. It doesn't really do anything. You're pretty much stuck here. There's an interesting theory that this is an alternate timeline. And that Fox is stuck here for eternity. playing with letters. Anyway, this is it for Let's Play Star Fox. I really want to thank you. Have a great rest of your day. Thanks for watching, as always.